This training session is about the identification of the path for an effective strategy, since startup entrepreneurs may feel overwhelmed by the vast number of choices they face. We're going to talk about definitions, how to formulate strategy in a complex environment, the concept of the vision and mission, the different levels of strategy, and some tools that can be used while determining our business strategy. The term was actually originated from a Greek word, combination, stratos and agin, which is guiding the army. And it was first established in business in 1951. Let me start by saying, what is not strategy? Strategy is simply planning is not strategy. Emphasis on operational effectiveness is not strategy. What is strategy? Business strategy refers to the actions and decisions that a company takes in order to reach its business goals and to be competitive in its industry. It defines what the business needs to do to reach its goals, which can help guide the decision-making process for hiring and resource allocation. A business strategy helps different departments work together, ensuring departmental decisions support the overall direction of the company. There are some reasons why a business strategy is very important for startup business. These reasons include planning, as a business strategy helps a startup to identify the key steps to be taken in order to reach its business goals. It's an important process of which allows a startup to identify and evaluate the company's strengths and weaknesses, creating a strategy that will capitalize on its strengths and give them the tools to overcome or eliminate its weaknesses. It allows it to effectively allocate resources for business activities, which automatically makes a startup more efficient. It gives a startup more control over the activities performed to reach its organizational goals. And by identifying a clear plan for how to reach its goals, a startup can focus on capitalizing on strengths, using them as a competitive advantage that makes the company unique. Some definitions of strategy. Sandler said that strategy is the determination of the basic long-term goals of an enterprise and the adoption of courses of actions and the allocation of resources necessary for carrying out these goals. Andrew said that it's a pattern of decisions in an organization which formulates goals, objectives, and purposes and produces principal policies and plans to achieve those goals. And another definition is that strategy is the direction and scope of an organization over the long term, which achieves advantage in a changing environment throughout its configuration of resources and competences with the aim of fulfilling stakeholders' expectations. The stakeholder expectations are significant. Some of the main characteristics that bear in entrepreneurial strategy is the ability that they keep in a startup to adapt in a continuously changing environment, is the creation of the competitive advantages through resource allocation, defining the scope of activities as well as the business's direction in a long-term way, and meeting the market's needs as well as the stakeholders' expectations. So for startup ventures, the core choices between different aspects such as technology, identity, customers, and competitions are what defines the strategy for the startup ventures. And the choices that they make drives them into a chosen path, which eliminates all other paths that could be taken. There are six main key components of a business strategy, and they include the vision and the business objectives, the core values, a SWOT analysis, the tactics that a business overtakes, the resource allocation plan, and measurements on how all the above are taking place. Let's talk about a bit about the strategic vision and a mission. The vision or a mission is an answer to the question that businesses ask, where do I see my business in the future? The vision is what do we as a business aspire to become in the future? And the mission statement is what we are doing as a business. Oftenly, a mission statement is considered to be the beginning of a strategy formulation. It's the first step. Basic elements for a vision and a mission statement is that they describe the future business scope. They specify the desired future size of the business in sense of business scale. They focus on products, markets, and technology. They focus on competition. They give the image of the company and relationships with their stakeholders. They describe a culture that is to be achieved, and they define the role of management and business structure. As we see in this pyramid, the vision is on the top of the pyramid, which leads down to tactics. Vision is the business aspiration. It goes down to the mission, as into why the company exists and what the founders envisioned. The objectives, the result that a company aims to achieve, the strategy, which is the long-term plan designed to achieve those objectives, the approach, which is the methodology for executing long-term plan, the tactics. The tactics, creating a vision. Let's see some examples. Starbucks, what is its mission? Its mission is to inspire and nurture the human spirit, one person, one cup, and one neighborhood at a time, which goes down to its values. TripAdvisor. TripAdvisor mission statement is to inspire and enable people to confidently explore, experience, and share our world. It has a specific vision statement. It's on our commitment to provide a trusted resource for travelers. As you see, these vision and mission statements are quite important. The levels of business strategy. We have three different levels in business strategy: the corporate level, the business level, and the functional level. The corporate level strategy is mainly a long-range, action-oriented, integrated, and comprehensive plan formulated by the top management. It's more mainly used to ascertain business lines, expansion, and growth, takeover and mergers, diversification, integrations, new areas for investment and divestment, and so forth. The business level, which is the next part, it's the strategies that relate to a particular business are known as business level strategies. It is developed by general managers who convert mission and vision into concrete strategies. It is like a blueprint for the entire business. And the next level is the functional level, which is dropped down to departments and how the business is actually managed. Going onwards to some tools that in entrepreneurial strategy are used. One basic tool is the SWOT analysis. The SWOT analysis is actually a compilation of your company's strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. The primary objective of a SWOT analysis is to help organizations develop a full awareness of all the factors that are involved in making a business decision. It can help your business identify what is doing right and what needs to be changed in the organization. And the process is surprisingly simple. SWOT analysis actually is a planning methodology that helps organizations build a strategic plan to meet goals, improve operations, and keep their businesses relevant. It actually, as you can see in this template, it takes into account the internal and the external environment that a company operates on. In an internal environment, we analyze the strengths. What are your business strengths? In what way your business is better than others? Do you have any unique technical or professional skills that your business possesses? What are your strengths as perceived by your competitors? And weaknesses, what are your weaknesses according to your internal assessments? In what way your peers stand above you? Improvement areas where you can focus upon. What are your weakness areas as perceived by your competitors? In the external environments, we try to analyze the opportunities and the threats. Such opportunities could be like the unique features that you can provide to your potential clients? What are the various opportunities being available in terms of regions? What are the different attributes which have positive impact on your business? As in threat goes, the absence or lack of any features in your product or service. What are the areas where your peers are doing well above your products or services? And the absence of perhaps some inadequate financial resources to support the various potential business opportunities that you have in front of you. Another tool is the pest analysis. In the pest analysis, we analyze political, economic, social, and technological aspects of the company's surroundings. In a political and analysis of the political environment, we see and we deal with ecological and environmental issues, with current legislation home markets, and perhaps for some pending future legislation that is going to be implemented in the country that we're working on, the international legislation, the regulatory bodies and processes, government policies, trading policies, international pressure groups, and so on. In the economic environment, we see the economy situation in the country that we are doing our business. We see general taxation issues, taxation specific to products and services. We see market and trade cycles. We see seasonality and weather issues if our business is have anything to do with that. We see international trade and monetary issues. In social aspects, we see demographics, consumer attitudes and opinions, brand, company, and technology image, consumer buying patterns, and so on. In the technology, we see competitive, competing technology development, research funding, maturity of technology, information and communication, the consumer buying mechanisms, potential innovation, and global communications. The pest analysis, a second tool is the pest analysis, which includes environmental and legal, besides the ones that we saw before, the social, the economic, the political, the environmental, it has the technological and the legal aspects, which are highly important, depend on the business that you're focusing on. As you can see in an example, the analysis of Coca-Cola, which is a company that gives examples in a lot of areas, in a political analysis, perhaps in some countries, Coca-Cola must follow FDA rules to provide people with the right beverages. In economic aspects, most of incomes is from sale of soft drinks. Social, if they have launched healthy beverages in the US, if they need to do the same in countries such as Japan and China. Technological is how to use the social media for effective promotion. They use right technology in producing fine products in a short time. Environmental, how they must operate in areas where there's no shortage of water or a shortage of water. Legal, the company should avoid indulging in any legal controversies, which is highly important for them. So when we're talking about a startup business strategy, there are a few steps that we need to take into account. The first step is we need to define our business and our vision. Defining your vision is important. It will become the driving force of your business. And there are some questions that will help clarify your business and your future business's vision. Who is the customer? In what business, in what sector are you in? What are you going to sell? What product or what service are you going to sell? What is your plan for growth? What is your primary competitive advantage? In an exercise, people that are thinking about creating a business, these are main questions that they need to answer, firstly for themselves and in order to make their business plan. Secondly, write down the goals. Create a list of goals with a brief descriptions of action items. If your business is a startup, you will want to put more effort in your short-term goals. Often, a new business concept must go through a period of research and development before the outcome can be very accurately predicted for longer time frames. Create two set of goals, a short term, which can range up to 12 months, and a long term that can be from 2 to 5 years. And while you do that, explain as specifically as possible what you want to achieve. Start with your personal goals, then list your business goals. This is very important when it comes to startups, where the founder is and his goals are the business goals, especially in the beginning. Thirdly, understand your customer. It is not realistic to expect that you can meet the needs of everyone. No business can do that. Choose your target market very carefully. Overlook this area and you will be disappointed with the performance of your business. Get this right and you will be more than pleased with the results, because you must be very specific as to who are you targeting for a customer and what are their specific needs. Needs. What unmet needs do you your prospective customers have? How does your business meet these needs? It is unusually something that the customer does not have, or a need that is not currently being met. Identify those unmet needs. Wants. Think of this as your customer's desire or wish. It can also be a deficiency. Problems. Remember that people buy things or services to solve a specific problem. A product or your services solve. Perceptions. What are the negative and positive perceptions that customers have about you, your profession and its products or services? Identify both the negative and positive consequences. You will be able to use that, what you learn, when you start marketing and promoting your business in the next level. Fourth, learn about your from your competition. You can learn a lot about your business and customers by looking at how your competitors do business. Here are some questions that will help you learn from your competition and focus on your customer. What do you know about your target markets? What sort of competitors do you have? How are competitors approaching the specific market? What are the competitors' weaknesses and strengths? Do the SWOT analysis for them as well. It can be used both ways. How can you improve both upon the competition's approach? What are the lifestyles, demographic, and psychographics on your ideal customer? Fifth, don't forget that financial plays a big part in how to formulate your startup business strategy. How will you make money? What is your breaking point? How much profit potential does your business have? Take the time to invest in preparing specific financial projections. These projections should take into account the collection periods for your accounts receivables, outstanding customer accounts, as well as the payment terms for your suppliers. For example, perhaps you are being made to pay your bills in 30 days, but you have to wait 45, 60 or more days to get paid from your customers. The cash flow projections will show you how much working capital you need during those gaps in your cash position. Since the financial are very important in startup business, and I think there is a thematic area later on speaking about financing startup businesses. Sixth, identify your marketing strategy. There are four steps to creating a marketing strategy for your business. The first step is identify all target markets. Define who is your ideal customer on or target market. Most companies experience 80% of their business that comes from 20% of their customers. It makes sense then to direct your time and energy towards those customers who are most important to your business. Qualify the best target markets. The purpose of this step is to further qualify and determine which customer profile meets the best odds of success. The strategy is to position your business at the same level as the majority of buyers you are targeting. It is critical to figure out who your best customers are and how to best position your company in that marketplace. Identify tools, strategies, and methods. Market you cannot access, it's a market that you cannot serve. Marketing is the process of finding, communicating, and educating your primary market about your products and services. Choose a combination of tools and strategies that, when combined, increase the odds of your startup business success. And it's very important to test marketing strategies and tools. Take the time to test all business assumptions, especially when you're making major expenditures. There are six steps to startup growth strategy that actually work. The first is know your value proposition. Identify your target audience. Establish KPIs, key performance indicators, that will allow you to see how you're performing at each period of time. Always monitor your competition and what they are doing. Make smart hires, because hiring is an important part of especially a startup's strategy. And scale responsibly. Summing up, which was a very short presentation, but when it comes to strategy, you must take into account that the word choose is very critical. For successful entrepreneurship, one should not completely depend on the above strategies that we mentioned. The strategies that not help in eliminating uncertainties, they may arise, but yes, it surely can give a crystal clear framework of solutions to the problems. So choices, taking into account the input of the information that you have on any particular time, is very important, and how you manage to go through them. Some exercises that we can do leaving these lessons is that you can choose from your favorite startup companies or any other and find their mission statement. Choose a well-known company and make a SWOT analysis and a PEST analysis of how you perceive their business strategy. And then when you're formulating your own business plan, try to make all of the above implemented in your own startup idea. So thank you for your time. It was a very short presentation, but I think that entrepreneurial strategy is quite important, especially for startups. You must take into account all of the above mentioned while preparing your business plan and taking your business into the market. Thank you very much.